are looking forward to our handing of the greetings ceremony today. Afterwards, we are going to have a covered dish dinner downstairs. If you didn't bring a covered dish, there will be plenty of food. Please come down and join us, and I think it will be a great time of fellowship. So, don't be shy. Come on down and join us for our covered dish dinner after the service. Christmas caroling will be Friday, December 15th. We've had great times going out Christmas caroling these years that I've been here. And we've kind of made it a tradition to hit the two close-by nursing homes, Siena Hills, and then I believe it is Adena Health and Rehabilitation Center out there in Harrisville. So we'll gather here at the church about 6 o'clock and do a little practicing, and then we'll go to the two nursing homes and do our songs, our carols, and then we'll try to hit a couple local members who cannot make it to church because of health problems or because they are shut-ins. So that should be a good evening, our Christmas caroling night, Friday, December 15th. You can see the great job our mission for our Christmas shoebox did, the results there, the Presbyterian Women Thank Offering. We thank you for giving. We really believe that the more you give, the more God blesses. And God blesses you both financially and spiritually and emotionally as you become a good giver. So we want to thank everyone who gave to those mission projects. Christmas concert is coming up December 10th. We need cookies for that concert. See Alberta if you are able to make some cookies. We're looking forward to Danny's yearly concert, which has also become a tradition here. Next week, next Sunday, we will have a congregational meeting, and then we will provide the slate of officers for 2018. We want to get our nominating committee together for 2018, so we'll have two members at large elected for that, and also approval of our budget for next year. So that will be a short meeting after church next week, so we hope you can stick around for that. Our Schwann's fundraiser is about over, so if you haven't purchased the food yet, please think about that to add to the fundraiser that we've got going. And you can see the other announcements in the bulletin. Check those out for yourself. Are there any announcements from the congregation this morning? Anything we need to know about? Any announcements from anyone this morning? Yes, Nancy.
The session has decided this year, since we don't have an abundance of orders for poinsettias, that we're going to purchase silk ones. They'll be $10, and if anyone would like to do a live one, they can bring them and put them ready. Older, but it's up to you to take care of them.
Okay, so because over the last few years our orders have gone way down, we decided to go with silk poinsettias. And if you want to contribute to that, see Nancy. If you want to buy live ones, we'll put them up here, but we ask that you would watch over them.
The ones up there right now, we got from the tree out in the hallway. They're
okay, we're ready for our children's sermon. Kids, come on down.
Good morning, kids. Has everybody
Everybody hears that? The book about the elf on the shelf, right? So they're hoping that the elf will come sometime this month. Putting lights up around the house and decorations up around the house. Now, Stanley, yeah. Yesterday, I decided to decorate the house for Christmas and get ready for Christmas. I thought, you know what? I'm going to put lights up on the outside and put the tree up and all that. It only took me about 2 hours to do that. I was wrong. It took all day to do that. It takes a lot of time to get ready. Today, we're having a special service called the Hanging of the Greens. It's one of our favorite services here. We're getting ready for Christmas. You guys are going to help. You're going to help bring up some decorations and set up the nativity scene, all that. And one thing I wanted to tell you is when we get ready for Christmas, we don't want to forget the reason for the season. All these decorations mean something. For example, the wreaths that you see that we're going to be hanging up, those represent crowns. Jesus wore a crown of thorns before they put him on the cross, but they found out that when Jesus was resurrected from the dead, he was the King of Kings, so he deserved a golden crown. Also, Christmas trees represent a tree which Jesus was hung on the cross. So we got to remember that whenever you see a Christmas tree, that represents that Jesus was hung on the cross for our sins because he loved us so much. Another thing I wanted to talk about, we put lights on the trees and lights on our houses. This represents that Jesus is the light of the world. In other words, he taught us all about God. And whenever you learn something, a light goes on in your mind. He taught us all about God. We learned about God. And then he taught people how to love each other and care for each other and how to love God. Yeah. How about that? So, we want to keep all of those things in mind. And if we do, as we get ready for Christmas, then we'll realize that Jesus is the reason. Let's pray. Lord, we thank you that